Hello, this is a virtual microscopy slide of a chronic peptic ulcer, and here on the left and on the right, we are looking at the intact gastric mucosa. In the center, you'll see that there is a crater where there is a defect in the gastric mucosa, and this is the region of the ulcer. The ulcer edges, as I'm pointing to on the left and on the right, are straight and punched out. They are not heaped up or rolling. If they are heaped up, we will worry about a cancer that has ulcerated. But with this punched out appearance, which we will see later on grossly, we are more reassured that this is a benign ulcer. At the base of the ulcer, there are usually several different zones, but before we go there, let me just point out to you a structure here. There is an elongated structure here with a central lumen. This is a sizable blood vessel, and you can see that the blood vessel is actually quite close to the base of the ulcer. If this ulcer were to erode into this blood vessel, there may be catastrophic bleeding. The patient will have severe hypotension or hemorrhagic shock, and this can actually lead to death from exsanguination. Now let's look at the base of the ulcer, and right on the surface, usually we will see this zone where you can see these pink strands here of fibrin, a meshwork of fibrin, and this is admixed with lots of neutrophils. So this is the zone of fibrinoinflammatory exudate. Just deep to this would be the zone of necrosis. So we can see necrotic tissue. Sometimes it just appears quite blue and hazy. So this is the zone of necrosis. Below that, we can see a lot of small blood vessels. These are all red blood cells located within the lumina of small newly formed blood vessels. And this is the zone of granulation tissue. And as we go deeper, we then see the final zone, the deepest zone, which is the zone of fibrosis or scarring. And this appears quite pink because the fibroblasts have actually laid down collagen, and this is the region of the scar of the ulcer. So depending on how deep the ulcer is, it may heal with scarring. This particular ulcer is actually quite deep. Let me show you the level of the original muscularis propria. This is the muscularis propria. And you can see that this ulcer has kind of gone even deeper than the muscularis propria. So if this were to go on untreated, it will potentially perforate. And perforation can give rise to peritonitis. Let me show you another example, which is less deep. This is another example of a chronic peptic ulcer. Again, we have the intact mucosa on both sides, and this is the base of the ulcer. This thick pink layer here is the muscularis propria, and we can see that this ulcer only kind of goes into the submucosa and a little bit into the muscularis propria, so this is a more shallow ulcer. Let me just zoom in, and again we can appreciate this is fibrinoinflammatory exudate, and we have some necrotic tissue, which is not so clearly seen in this particular ulcer, but we have lots of newly formed blood vessels here, and some of them are leaky, so you can see the red blood cells actually have extravasated out of the blood vessels. This is the zone of granulation tissue, and as I go deeper, we have a little bit of fibrosis, and it's more clearly seen in this area. So we have the zone of fibrosis or scarring, and below that we have the viable and intact muscularis propria. Let's have a look at a gross example. Here is a gross example of a chronic peptic ulcer. This is the mucosal surface of the stomach. Here is the serosa, and we can see that this ulcer has not perforated all the way through the gastric wall. When we look at higher magnification, we can see that this is a very punched out ulcer with very sharply demarcated edges. It is oval in shape. Here is actually a blood vessel in the base of the ulcer, so it is likely also that this ulcer was bleeding massively. And this is the classical appearance of a peptic ulcer. This is in contrast to a cancer, which has ulcerated where usually we would see very thick, heaped up edges. If you scroll down on this page, you will also be able to see other bits of information. And all this is available in our virtual pathology museum in our online resource known as Pathweb. To obtain free registration, you can look for the link in this video description. In summary, this is an example of a chronic peptic ulcer where we see an ulcer with sharply demarcated, punched-out edges and a relatively clean base. In the ulcer base, there is fibrinoinflammatory exudates, followed by a zone of necrosis. Then there is granulation tissue with newly formed blood vessels. And finally, deeper to that, we have the zone of collagen deposition or scarring. These ulcers may penetrate into large blood vessels, causing massive bleeding, gastrointestinal hemorrhage, or they can also penetrate through the full thickness of the wall of the stomach, giving rise to perforation and peritonitis. Thank you.